Hi, I'm Doug Hannon. You might know me as the bass professor. But back when I started, I was just a fisherman like everybody else, and I went off in pursuit of big fish. And in order to do that successfully, I had to study the fish. And I also maintained fish alive for reasons of study. What I found over the years is that I became sort of a rare commodity, and I got tapped to consult for zoos and other display places in order to keep fish alive and maintain fish for public display. This led me to learning all about the chemical treatments necessary to keep these big fish alive. Along the way, tournament fishing began and then exploded into a national phenomenon. Whenever anything gets that high profile, it of course draws critics. And the critics were about whether or not these fish were dying, whether or not the tournaments were over-exploiting fish. So I became involved in actually helping to keep these fish alive and developing the weigh-in procedures, cooling, chilling tanks, and actually making chemical formulas that would ensure that these fish could be released alive and disease and fungus-free to fish for again. Along the way, I came in contact with many people, but one of the most fruitful relationships was with Tony Gergely, who was a microbiologist at the time for a large aquarium chemical company. Tony and I got together, and with Tony's expertise and my knowledge of what needed to be done, we came up with some formulas that were just absolutely dynamite for keeping fish alive. They work by tranquilizing the fish, for one, because fish under stress need tranquilizing. They don't need to be hyped up. So we tranquilize the fish, we put blood electrolytes in the water, you know, the same type of things that you need when you work out in the sun. You need to get your salts up. So we balance the electrolytes of the fish, calm them down, and we also give them the things they need for long-term, harmless but effective antibiotics and fungicides that actually work into the tissues and the skin of the fish, are very short-term, but give them that transition from captivity back into the water and back to a healthy lifestyle for you to catch them again. What these products do for the future of our fishing is really essential if you're going to consider the impact that people have down the road with more and more people, more and more interest, and more commercialization of our sport. And what really needs to happen is that the fish that we catch need to survive. You know, I tell people, you don't eat your golf balls, okay? And you don't kill your bass. Bass is a sport fish and it's too valuable to be caught only once. So by the use of these chemicals, whether you're a recreational fisherman and just holding your fish so you can have a good picture to remember the day, or whether you're a tournament fisherman and out there in the heat of competition and having to bring them in under rough conditions and hard water, and all of that through a weigh-in process and get them back in the water, you want those fish to survive, and that's exactly what these chemicals provide. You know, I've always thought that fishing requires a license, and if you look at the definition of license, it's a privilege, and it's also a responsibility. And what we have to do, if we're going to continue to enjoy our fishing and our environment, is to have an enlightened self-interest, to learn about what we need to know in order to preserve what we love. And that's exactly where we have to go. Whenever you fish, I don't care what kind of fishing you're doing, we want you to think about the survival of the fish that you're enjoying. And a lot of that comes from treating them properly, maintaining them properly, and releasing them alive to fight again.